The Swedish hate speech law, Hets mot folkgrupp, is so extremely vague that it is actually outright dangerous for the citizens of this country. Ridiculous hate speech laws is something that plagues Europe as a whole, but I dare say that Sweden has to be at least somewhere in the top 5 when it comes to having stupid laws against hate. This video is going to be about why that is. In Sweden, there exists a central managing authority known as the Chancellor of Justice. It's responsible for enforcing and making sure that all different authorities within government follow and obey our nation's laws. And they alone can invoke a general prosecution against anyone who is deemed to have committed the hate crime Hets mot folkgrupp. And after this has been done, the cases get dropped into the lap of our courts. But they act in extremely peculiar ways when it comes to their view on what constitutes hate speech, or Hets mot folkgrupp, as we call it in Sweden. For instance, previous chancellors of justice have decided that Scientologists shouldn't be protected by the same hate speech laws which also protects, for example, Jews and Muslims. The reason? Scientology has too few followers in Sweden. Now, I'm not tolerant enough to see Scientology as anything more than a cult that preys upon the weak for cash, but if we're now supposed to have a law that is going to protect different religious and racial groups against hate speech, shouldn't it also encompass all of them? Well, apparently not. In 2015, for instance, our Chancellor of Justice decided, reluctantly I should add, that ethnic Swedes can indeed be the victims of hate speech, but that we have to tolerate a greater amount of racist slurs and threats since we are the majority. So we have a law which primarily applies to groups of people who are not too small, not too big, but just the right size. Well, what is just the right size? Will anti-Semitism get a pass in the future, since the amount of Jews in this country keeps decreasing for every Muslim we get into the country? Is Jew-hating then just going to be okay because they're too few? Or if blacks become the majority in a country where they're now a minority, should they then all of a sudden be expected to just accept being called racial slurs by the white minority from time to time, just because they are then the biggest racial group? Of course not. Nobody reasons like this, except when it's about whites. So already here, the law is discriminatory, and it's unclear. And an unclear law is a shitty law. When it comes to Hets mot folkgrupp, we also face even worse problems with its definition. Let's read the actual definition of the law, and I'm gonna do my best to translate it for you. This description of the law is taken from Sweden's public prosecution authority. Hets mot folkgrupp. To publicly spread statements that are threatening or derogatory towards a group of people by referencing to race, skin color, national or ethnic heritage, religion or sexual orientation. Okay, now let's pick this crap apart. I don't have a problem with it being illegal to incite violence against certain racial groups. I think that's fine, but we need to define derogatory. I mean, depending upon which group of people we're talking about, they all have very different views of what it constitutes to being derogatory or insulting against them. And I also must add that if we're being extremely specific, the word used in the definition of the law isn't the word derogatory, it's actually the Swedish word missaktning. Missaktning means to show disdain or to despise. So this law just became even more unclear. What constitutes to show disdain? Or to despise, in any legal sense. Despise, in my view, is an extremely strong word, and immediately several of the convictions that have been made against people that were being classified as being Hets mot folkgrupp, according to Swedish law, then clearly wouldn't qualify. For instance, in one case in Sweden, a camping spot had a sign that read "No Gypsies Allowed" at its entrance, and the owner of the camping who put up the sign got convicted for hate speech or Hets mot folkgrupp. Now, would it be fair to say that the owner of the camping disliked Romani people, who he most likely were targeting by using the word gypsy on the sign? Definitely. I mean, let's cut to crap, of course. But would you be able to prove that he in fact despised them? Would you be able to measure the level of hatred he felt towards them based only upon that sign? Well, that was a rhetorical question, because you can't. No one can. And as it turned out, the man had put up the sign only after first having had extremely serious problems with a couple of Romani families at his camping. And finally, after having had one of his employees threatened with a knife by one of them, he then put up the sign. Shitty call? Definitely. Discriminatory? Sure. But proof that he actually despised them? Not really. It only proved that he feared for the safety of his employees and wanted to get rid of a very specific group who were harassing and threatening his staff. The Swedish Anti-Discrimination Act would have easily covered this case, since a group were being discriminated against due to their ethnicity. So Hets mot folkgrupp is just useless unless you want to make an example of someone, which they did with this man. And in the end, when it comes to taking something like this to a court of law, all you really have to go on is how insulting was the sign. Which then of course varies greatly, because Romanis, who are being targeted in this case, obviously consist of individuals, and they therefore take offense from different things and to a varying degree. I, for instance, had a Romani classmate who self-identified as being a gypsy. He called himself a gypsy. But if I call just any person of Romani descent a gypsy, he or she might become severely offended. It all depends. It's a fucking minefield. So the result is a law which will have its punishment severity determined by the person who screams the loudest, is the least white, and is the most offended. Brilliant. You might think that I'm being petty and that I'm just arguing about semantics, but isn't the fact that I kind of actually need to do so proof that this law is the complete opposite of a good law? A good law is clear, sound, and easy to enforce. Hets mot folkgrupp is none of the above. It's vague, subjective, and shit. Here's another crux with this dangerous and oppressive law. Those who support this train wreck of a law, they say that if a statement about a specific group of people lacks anything resembling a fair point or sound argument, or isn't a statement that is based upon facts, well then it's hets mot folkgrupp and is a criminal act. I can very easily show why that is complete and utter bullshit. Let us imagine, hypothetically, that a prophet of a certain religion married and later consummated that marriage with a 9-year-old girl, and that this prophet at the time of this marriage was 56 years old. Would you be wrong in saying that this prophet would have been, by all modern definitions of the word, a pedophile? Or at least someone who sexually exploited a minor. He was an adult and he had intercourse with a child. And let's say, hypothetically, that despite apologists desperately using secondary and indirect sources instead of direct testimony, and frantically obfuscating by meandering on about imprecise dating in order to make this child bride seem older than she really was, that the mainstream consensus within this religion all throughout its history is exactly what I just said. The prophet had sex with a 9-year-old girl, a child, hypothetically. This would still mean that despite you or me being able to easily back up what we said, a lot of followers of this religion would be severely insulted by our words. Would we be wrong? Nope. Would we insult people who might press charges against us for hets mot folkgrupp for implying that their prophet is a pedophile? Definitely. My position is, as a response, that people taking offense from you simply stating facts should never give them the upper hand in any court of law. This is obvious. But I'm willing to bet my left nut that you'd still risk being convicted for hets mot folkgrupp if you would, for instance, say something like that on public television or here on YouTube, or maybe even for just writing it in a text which you then choose to publish under your real name. You would still risk being convicted for hate speech even despite the fact that you are 100% factually correct. Which shows us that this is a law that is dangerous for the citizen. The law Hets mot folkgrupp is extremely fluid in its nature and is very generous when it comes to its definition and susceptibility towards public outcry. It's nothing more than a slippery and sinister law against insult, which in the case of criticism aimed against religion means that it in practice is a law against blasphemy in Sweden in 2018. Here's a short history lesson. Until the 1970s, Sweden had a law in place called trosfrid, roughly translated to peace of belief, but it was later scrapped motivated by that a law specifically protecting the believer against insult severely limits the right to freedom of speech for other citizens, which is true. But the removal of the law was also sadly later motivated by the existence of a new law which took its place, and that law was Hets mot folkgrupp, or Swedish law against hate speech and hurt feelings. So an old law against blasphemy went from being an infringement upon the citizen's freedom of speech to instead later warp into an extremely vague and very loosely defined new law, which to this day is in practice still just a law against blasphemy and different types of thought crimes. So we've repackaged the shit, but it still stinks. Now here's my final thoughts on the matter. Our law Hets mot folkgrupp should be immediately pushed through a paper shredder. The US, they've got it right with their First Amendment. And I hope that they keep defending it like the precious gem that it actually is, since I know that freedom of speech is being viciously attacked over there as well. Defend it with your life. Hets mot folkgrupp is a racist and oppressive law because it shows favoritism for specific racial groups within this nation's citizenry while letting others deal with racial slurs and state-funded cultural nihilism without even being able to confront the people who are responsible. The white majority is expected to be okay with racial insults and hate crimes, while minorities are free to squeal bloody murder as soon as their feels take a slight dent. Even if you belong to the ethnic white majority, you should still never be forced to accept racism or having your culture denigrated, and to even suggest such a thing shows that the people defining and enforcing our laws are unfit to work in higher office and that they have a complete lack of respect for the Swedish people, which begs the question what the fuck they're even doing in any form of authority position. To discriminate a person in Sweden based upon their gender, race, or creed is already illegal under Sweden's Discrimination Act, so the law Hets mot folkgrupp isn't about protecting the liberties and rights of the citizen. It's about something else. In Sweden's Discrimination Act, you can read about the rights of the citizen to be protected against limitations of his or her freedom, be it financial, social, or maybe even physical, due to gender, race, sexual orientation, or religion. But Hets mot folkgrupp is only about the regulation of speech, and more importantly, it's about how many people hears or reads something you write. In fact, the law has its punishment severity defined to a large part by how many hear your words or read your texts, and your wording in itself also matters. If you say something provocative but true about a religious or racial group, your delivery is, according to the Swedish law, also important. How fucking petty isn't that? So if you say something that is true, but in a vulgar manner, and thousands of people hear it, you might still get shit for it. The goalposts are being widened for each year regarding what constitutes racism, and soon encompasses critique against everything non-Western and non-white. And laws against hate speech keep spreading like a cancer, and they ruin the entire public debate on very important issues. And it no longer matters if you're factually correct. Today, the people who make sure that you end up behind bars are those who get the most insulted and scream the loudest. I will never and I have never supported the incitement of violence against minorities or encouraged discrimination against people of other races, but I will also never defend shitty ideas, disgusting traditions, and degenerate cultural practices from criticism just because the people supporting them happen to be non-white. It's idiotic to lower our moral standards as a society just because of the color of someone's skin. So to conclude, the only way to soften the harm that Western nations' multicultural chaos has inflicted upon ourselves is to use facts to confront and tear apart regressive and harmful cultural ideas and practices, and to in the end drag those who have subscribed to them kicking and screaming into the 21st century while showing a complete indifference to if they get insulted or not. And this cannot be done if we have a by now weaponized law, like Hets mot folkgrupp, with which dissidents can be targeted, eliminated, and branded as being unworthy to take part in the public debate. It has to go. Take care of yourself, and I want to thank you very much for listening. Bye.
I said, I'm not gonna hurt you. I'm just gonna bash your brains. I'm gonna bash them right the fuck in.